You know how pie charts work, right? You read them by the angle in the center of a slice. But is that true? Because if it is, then it doesn't matter if we scale slices differently since it doesn't change the angle. But it also means that when we punch out the center of a pie, like in a donut chart, that would be bad because we're taking out the most obvious way of seeing that angle. But what if it's not true? Wouldn't we have to question many of the other things that we like to assume about pie charts? I've actually done some research on pie charts, and I will show you 5 reasons why we're not using angle to read pie slices. Also, donut charts are just as good as pie charts, but changing the radius of a slice is bad. Let's take a look. Before we go into the science, let's look at what pie charts are even for. A common criticism of pie charts is that you can't see small differences between the pie slices. This is especially true when you compare them to bar charts. Can you tell which of these pie slices is the largest? Can you see which of these bars is the tallest? Of course you can see with the bars, even as I obnoxiously change their values. But it's not a fair comparison. If I want to make this fair to the pie chart, I'd align the pie slices on a common edge too. Now which slice is the largest? This might look silly, but it's an actual fair comparison. But it's not what pie charts are for. Let's try something else. Can you tell what percentage the yellow bar is of the total? Without looking at the pie chart or the table, I mean. The pie chart works well for part-to-whole comparisons, meaning what fraction or percentage of the total each individual piece is. That is much harder to do with a bar chart where you'd have to sum up the bars first. The pie already does that for you. You can do something similar with bars by using a stacked bar chart. Which bar segment is the largest now? It turns out that we're actually worse at reading stacked bar charts than pie charts. But this is the fair comparison with a pie chart because both are stacked and don't start on a common baseline. What a lot of arguments against pie charts get wrong is that they expect them to work like bar charts. But why would they? We already have bar charts. Pie charts serve a different purpose. So how do pie charts work? We draw pies by angle, but we might read them in at least 3 different ways. Yes, there's angle, but there's also the length of the arc on the outside of the slice, and there's the area of the slice. My former student Drew Scow and I ran some studies a few years ago where we showed people specially constructed visuals that were designed to allow them to only read angle, only arc length, or only area. We asked people to read the percentages off of these charts and then compared their answers to the values that we were actually showing them. We also had a simple donut chart and a donut version of the angle-only visual. All of them were compared to a standard pie chart as the reference. To show the results from this study, I'm using what are called confidence intervals. They show how far off people's answers were from the actual values that we showed them. The pie chart serves as the baseline here, so the pie error will always appear as 0 and will compare the other charts to it. The key here is whether the confidence interval for any of the other charts crosses the 0 line for the pie chart. If it does, then we can tell that chart apart from the pie chart in terms of accuracy. So in this case, the donut, the arc-only, and the area-only chart all cross the 0 line and so are no better or worse than the pie chart. But, and here it gets interesting, the confidence intervals for the 2 angle-only visuals do not intersect the 0 and are in fact much higher. If angle were the way to read pie charts, you'd expect people to correctly read a chart that shows only angle, or at least do no worse. What these results show, however, is that people's accuracy was much worse with the angle-only visuals. Also, if they used angle, how come they can read the donut chart, the arc-only, and even that weird area-only chart just as well as the pie chart? Something else must be going on here. Angle by itself can't be how we read pie charts. Donut charts are popular, and they're also useful to test the angle assumption. So we ran a separate study to see what impact the size of the hole in a donut would have. Based on a previous study, you can probably guess how this turned out, but it actually got a bit more complicated. As you can see here, the confidence intervals for the donuts cross the 0 line for the pie chart, except for the last one, which just misses the 0. That's odd, because it looks basically the same as the arc-only chart from the first study, which did not show this behavior. When confidence intervals almost touch the 0, like in this case, it's hard to tell if that shows a real difference or it's just a fluke, maybe because people weren't paying attention as well. So it's possible that if we had run the study with more people, we would have gotten more consistent results across all the different donuts. But the bulk of this study and the previous study show no ill effects from removing the center of the donut, which again means that A, donuts are no worse than pie charts, and B, it's not angle, because you can't see the angle with donuts, and yet they're no different. What about the weird pie charts that are common in information graphics? Well, we studied those too. We made 4 pie chart variations to test things like larger slices, an exploded pie, and 2 versions of distorted pie charts. One was cut into a square and one into an ellipse that kind of resembled a 3D pie chart. Let's look at the bias here first, meaning how much people over or underestimated the values from these charts relative to the pie chart. I'm again using confidence intervals here. Above the line in this case means overestimation, below means underestimation, and if it crosses the 0, then that chart is no different than the pie chart. And look at that, people way overestimate the larger slice. Why would its value appear larger if we used angle to read these charts? That makes no sense. But the bigger slice has more area and a longer arc on the outside. So if it's one of those two visual cues we're reading, then it fits. Also, when we look at accuracy, we see that the unusually shaped charts do much worse than normal pie, even though we didn't change the angle. Area and arc length, of course, behave in really weird ways, though. As an aside here, the exploded pie chart is interesting too. We didn't really expect it to make a difference, but it's clearly worse than normal pie chart. None of the visual cues are different in this case, though. Angle, arc length, and area have not changed. But we have taken it out of its frame of reference, which seems to be a bad thing. This doesn't tell us anything about the visual cue we're using, but it's something to be avoided. When we draw a pie chart, we draw it by angle. It's the easiest way to construct it. You take your numbers, turn them into percentages of the total, and then multiply those by 360 to get the angle in degrees that each slice should cover. But it doesn't mean that we also read it like that. It's such a deeply held assumption that we use angle for pie slices that most people never question it. Even highly respected and widely cited papers, like this one by Bill Cleveland and Robert McGill, point out that area and arc length are possibly involved in our reading of pie charts, but then go on to equate pies with angle anyway. No study I'm aware of has ever actually found angle to be the mechanism we use to read pie charts. Of course, there are very few studies that look into how pie charts actually work. A commonly cited paper is this one by Walter Crosby Eales from 1926. 1926! And it's found that the majority of people read the pies by arc length, not angle. So it's really a mystery where the angle comes from. It seems to be just an assumption based on how we draw pies, without any actual evidence. Now, of course, you might argue that we can see certain angles very easily, like a right angle for 25% or a straight line for 50%, and that's clearly true. But I don't think we're reading these as angles. Instead, we're recognizing them as distinct shapes. There are also edge cases that don't tell us how we read pie charts in general. So after all the talk about how angle is not it, which one is it? Arc length or area? Well, spoiler alert, we still don't know. But I did make an attempt at figuring it out by using 3D pie charts. It turns out that when you use parallel projection, the area of a slice stays the same no matter how you spin it around the pie. It just gets long and skinny, or short and wide. Even with the parallel projection, though, there's quite a bit of distortion in both angle. And arc length. People's responses should be influenced by that distortion if they used one of those visual cues. But that does not appear to be the case. I've made a video about this study that I'm linking to in the notes below, but the main result was that area had a slight edge over arc length and angle. It's a small difference, however, so it's not a slam dunk for area. I still think it's area, though. It's not my goal here to push a pie chart agenda. I really don't care if you use pie charts or not. What I am trying to achieve is to show you a bit of research that calls the old assumptions about pie charts into question. That doesn't make them the right choice for everything, and they're clearly overused. But I think it's important to separate the ridicule they often receive and the hyperbole from the facts and the science. And hopefully, this will make you ask more questions in the future about what we actually know, and more importantly, what we don't know about even simple chart types. Speaking of knowing more, there are links to papers and other resources in the video description below. If you learned anything from this video or found it interesting, I'd very much appreciate it if you could like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and take cake. Bye. Bye.